Today we're here at Farizon Auto Day 2023 in Shangtan in China's Hunan province. If you've seen our videos about the Farizon G2M and the Farizon SuperVAN, you'll know that Farizon is Geely's commercial vehicle brand. They've only been around for 7 years, but they're already making great progress here in China, across Asia, and in the Middle East. And now they're gunning for Europe too. The Farizon SuperVAN that we checked out in September is already revolutionizing the way we look at vans and van-based vehicles, and is now on pre-sale in 3 European countries as well. We're gonna get to drive this thing in the new year, so check out that video. If you haven't already, you can see our video about it in the top corner of this one. But no, today is not about the Farizon SuperVAN. You see, at brand events like this, the hosts tend to bring something rather special, and today is no exception. You may have seen prototypes of this truck, but today we can reveal the production version of a truck that is so special, you'll want to go out and get a truck driving license just so you can make driving one of these things your daily job. That truck is, of course, the Farizon Homtruck. Here we are with the Homtruck. Let me tell you a few little features about this. I'm going to start with the logo. This is the Farizon logo. And if you didn't know already, it's defined as a T for technology, a U for user oriented, and a zero for zero carbon emissions, which is what Farizon are trying to do. Now, this is of course called the Homtruck, which is the uniting home and truck, because nowadays trucking journeys are taking longer than ever. Truckers need to have a place that they can call home out on the road. So it's a combination of home and truck. Now, as you can see, it does look very techy. It looks very modern and futuristic. There are a few features I want to highlight. First of all, and we'll start down by the bottom, we've got some millimeter wave radars here. These help us to have better safety with the truck, to see what's going on around us. The part of a comprehensive autonomous driving package, including LiDAR units that give this truck level 2++ autonomous driving capability. And these trucks are connected to Farizon's stargazing platform, which uses the 9 Geely satellites that are in orbit to offer precise location information, enabling the truck to see 50 kilometers ahead and optimize energy efficiency when going uphill and downhill. Here you can see we've got really slick aerodynamics. There are a few aerodynamic features in this truck. One are these air outlets here, these air vents that go around the side and channel air around the side of the truck. Then we've got this front panel here. On most trucks that you've seen, this panel is flat, which of course isn't great for aerodynamics, but it is good for crash structure and strength. This was a big engineering challenge for the guys at Farizon to make one that is shaped like this and is nice and smooth, that allows the air to channel around and still keep the same safety of a normal truck. You'll also notice, normally you get hooks, kind of handles on here that you can grab so you can step up and do the window. Here they've integrated them into this bonnet so you can put your foot on there, you can hang on the truck like this, and then you can clean your window. Again, another piece of aerodynamic information built into there. You'll see more cameras up there in the dashboard. You'll also see one camera here. There are regulations in a truck that you need to be able to see this area of the truck. This has a little screen inside, I'll show you later, that shows you this downward view of the truck. Now, if you follow me around the side and look up here, you'll also see we've got cameras for wing mirrors. So instead of these big ears that you normally get on the side of a truck, this one has cameras. Again, you can see those inside the cabin. And if you come around to the side here, you'll see this A-pillar is certainly more raked than you would get on a normal truck. Normally this goes straight up. And again, that is for crash test safety. What they've done here is optimize the angle of that A-pillar to make sure that it has the best aerodynamic flow, whilst being able to make it easy to get into the cabin without banging your head, which again is something that is very important on a truck like this. The Homtruck actually boasts an incredible drag coefficient of just 0.351 CD, or 0.343 CD in optimal mode. This truck is the XL size, which means that you get the full height of the cabin and you get the full depth as well. I'm going to take you inside in a moment to show you what's going on inside the truck. You can also get an L version of this, which comes in 2 different heights, a lower version, which only has 2 steps here, and a bigger version, which has 3 steps like this one. So if you look here, you see our truck has 3 steps, so we have a bit more space that we have to use to get up into this truck. But let's go and take a look inside, and we'll show you what the Homtruck has inside the interior. So from the driving position of the Homtruck, you can see that we have quite a fancy setup, actually, I would say. We've got a really large steering wheel. That's kind of what you expect in a truck, but it's nicely lined in this soft leather. Looks quite swoopy. You get your control buttons on there, some physical switch gear. You get a nice large screen for your central controls there. You also get a really big one here, probably about a 15-inch screen in the middle that gives you all these different apps and things that you can connect to with this truck, and a little bit of physical switch gear down there as well. We also have in here a drawer where you can put some drinks and things like that. You've got over here a screen in the corner. This one, as you'll see when we take this thing for a drive, is actually the view from the camera up here. So it's essentially your left view mirror. We have another one on that side, and above it another screen that looks down in front of the cabin as well. You've also got a sun blind here as well, of course, because truckers often get the sun in their eyes. That pops back up there. And of course, you've got your CB radio up there because truckers always need that. But this chair itself, this seat, is actually quite comfortable. We've got air suspension here, got an armrest on this side, and, you know, quite a high door on there. Wouldn't actually be too bad driving this thing. But that's not what makes this the Homtruck or the Homtruck. So let's go and take a look at the back, and I'll show you a few of the creature comforts. Now, the first thing you'll see, and this isn't unique to the Homtruck, is of course that we have a bed here. We also have quite a bit of storage underneath there as well. And we've got a second bed up here because sometimes truckers do kind of tag team in so that one drives for long hours and the other one waits. But we get some nicer things than that. If you look over here in this unit, you'll see that under this ceramic panel, we've got ourselves a nice hob here for heating food up, and a sink with a tap so you can also wash your dishes in there as well. You've got more storage down here, and this thing folds out as a table so you can use that. Up at the top, if you want some baked beans, got yourself a nice Xiaomi microwave up there, and a few more switches for things like heaters and things like that. Now on this side, this is something you probably haven't seen in the truck before. This is a shower, full-size shower in there. You've got a proper jet over there. You've got some kind of ventilation as well. So that'd be actually a really nice thing, because then you don't have to worry about getting off at dirty truck stops, because they're usually not the nicest places in the world. So this is going to be a real benefit. But if we turn around here, we've actually got to see a little bit of storage up at the top there as well. We've got three boxes across the top, as well as the storage that is down there under the seat. Let me just show you one other thing as well that I almost forgot. I'm going to sit here. Here, we've got a fridge, so you can actually keep your food cool as well in the fridge. Food and drinks. Basically, you can live in this truck very, very comfortably. But anyway, now it's time for us to go and take a ride along and go and see what the electric version is like from the inside.
So as you can see, we've got the truck here right behind me. Gonna go and take a little ride along and let you know how the full battery electric version of this truck fares. Let's go and take a look. All right, let's climb up into the truck then. Let's go and take this thing for a ride. Let's see how it goes.
Okay, so we're now taking the truck for a ride. We've got our driver here. He's a licensed truck driver, so he's allowed to drive this thing around. The first thing you notice is just how quiet it is. I've never been in a truck that is as quiet as this. This is the full battery electric version of it. And you can see right here on our side, we don't have mirrors on this truck. We've actually got cameras which show us two different scenes. You've got a scene that's higher up and a scene that's lower down to help you protect vulnerable road users like cyclists. And then we've got another camera up here. I believe this one is looking directly down the front of the truck to make sure that you don't hit something. Again, on the other side, we've got more wing mirrors over there. You see, we get a really nice screen here in the center as well, with quite a few different apps on it. You've got Alipay, you've got your maps on there. This is probably quite advanced for a truck. I don't think you have a lot of that stuff in there. Certainly, the visibility is very good around here. We've got a really wide windscreen, gives you a full view of the road around you. There's another Homtruck over there, look at that. They are attractive things. They look quite unique out here on the street. And actually on my side of the cabin, I've got a reasonable amount of legroom here as well. If I look just down there, see a reasonable amount of legroom there. This is one of the shorter cabins, so this isn't one of the long journey ones. We do have a bed behind us with some bags on it and things like that. Another bed up there. We've also got a sunroof up there as well, which you don't tend to get on all trucks. So as you can hear, if you listen, it's absolutely silent in here, completely peaceful. That's because this is the full battery electric version. Now, there are two other versions of this truck. One of them is a methanol engine range extender. What that means is you have a methanol powered engine that doesn't drive the wheels, that only charges up an electric battery, and the battery sends power to electric motors that drive the truck. You also can get a full
methanol version of this truck, which basically is like a normal truck, like a diesel truck, where the engine actually drives the wheels. You can get different size engines. You can get a 14 litre engine for the full methanol version, or you can get 6 or 9 litre engines for the methanol range extender versions, depending on what kind of drivetrain you need. And that of course depends on what kind of topography you're going to be driving in. You're going to be driving in cold circumstances, you're going to be driving up hills, you're going to be driving in generally flat areas like somewhere like Hangzhou or Shanghai. That will basically define what kind of drivetrain you want.
Now, the electrified drivetrains on these have up to 578 kilowatts of power. That's quite a lot. It's pretty similar to the top-end electric cars, the difference being, as I mentioned with the G2M truck in that video, is the torque, which is obviously considerably higher in trucks because they have to pull much heavier loads. The range for this one, the electric truck, is 500 kilometers, and it runs on an 800 volt system for faster charging, but I'll come back to that in a second. The methanol range extender trucks, they have a maximum range of 1500 kilometers, and in fact, Farizon have just tested that out in sub-zero conditions. They got 1,341 kilometers of range on a single tank of methanol, and that drivetrain uses 45% less energy than traditional fuel trucks. Apparently it costs just £15.66 or 142.2 RMB to run for 100 kilometers, which is ridiculous. The power of the 14 liter methanol only engine, that's 510 horsepower, and even that consumes 30% less fuel than a standard diesel truck. But coming back to this truck, the electric one, the other great thing about it is that Geely Group has a lot of electric cars, as I'm sure you know. And believe it or not, you can use the exact same motors on the truck as you use on the cars. There's a lot of transferable technology there that can be used from one class of vehicle to another. And with this truck, you can charge it with double charging guns and get megawatt level charging. That'll get you about 80% charge in just 45 minutes. So basically the same time it takes to drop off a load at whatever location you are taking your goods to.
Has to be said that the ride quality up here is actually pretty decent as well. It feels quite comfortable. We've got some bumpy streets around here. That's a much bigger bump there that we've just gone over, but it is nice and smooth. We do get these big cushy seats. See down here, we've got big air cushions underneath the seats there. Okay, so what I've asked the driver to do now is to accelerate from a standing start to show just how fast we can go in this electric truck. So 3, 2, 1, go. Wow, already an instant push of acceleration there. He's being gentle here. We're definitely being a lot more careful than you might be, but the acceleration there was quite strong. I could feel that in the back of my spine. Really quite impressive there. As I said, this is just super quiet. It's a truck experience like no other. If you've ever been around a bus with a traditional diesel engine or around a truck, you'll have heard the engine straining to leave the bus stop or leave from a standing start. This thing inside is completely silent. The only thing we can hear is a little bit of suspension noise and also the beeps and the satellite navigation telling us where we need to go. If you've been a normal truck driver in the past and got used to driving around in loud, kind of noisy trucks, then you step into something like this, it's going to feel very much like you've just stepped into the future.
But no, there is one thing that this truck doesn't have. Not this one, this one actually has everything. I'm talking about this truck over here. What's this, I hear you ask? Well, it's the Homtruck Cabless. So what do you think of this? I mean, this looks very similar to those trucks that work at the airports pushing planes around. That's not a million miles from the truth, but there are some key differences. The first one being, there's no cab. This one doesn't have any space for people. And rather than pushing planes around, it's basically doing the exact same thing as a normal truck. It just doesn't need people. It's basically a level 4 autonomous truck, which means it can do things entirely on its own and finds great use in places like shipyards, where you get organized routes that it can follow, only with a little bit more flexibility. Now, just like the standard Homtruck over here, the Homtruck Cabless comes with a plethora of sensors like the LiDAR here and the cameras up there that help this thing avoid getting into accidents. The principle is quite similar to those autonomous robots that you see driving around car factories, working on a predefined route, only these come with a little bit more flexibility than that. I mean, can you imagine that this may be how the future of trucking looks, especially if trucking is done on main arterial routes between one depot and another? You may no longer need to have people involved. You could have autonomous delivery trucks like this going from one place to another. Trucks like this one and the Homtruck over there behind me are capable of something called convoying, which is where trucks line up very closely one behind the other. The aim of that is to basically improve the aerodynamics, therefore reducing power consumption and improving efficiency. Essentially, they see through the eyes of the truck at the front to avoid accidents so they don't plow into the back of each other. Very smart stuff. So as you can see, innovation in the Chinese automotive industry isn't just limited to cars, it's now expanding to trucks as well. And I'll be honest with you, in the trucking industry in China at least, innovation like this is sorely needed. Trucks need to be safer, they need to be smarter, and they need to be cleaner. Trucks actually make up only 10% of the vehicles on China's roads, but in terms of CO2 emissions, they represent more than half of that amount and 80% of the PM pollutants. One diesel truck is equivalent to 360 passenger cars. So as you can see, these guys are not doing things by halves, and in a situation where we need to look after the environment, that's really the only way. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, and if you do, thank you for subscribing. We'll catch you next time.